I was, I first remember seeing Jack Horkheimer on WPBT when he was giving a, I guess you could say, a play-by-play on the lunar eclipse that happened in the summer of 1975. I was about seven, almost 8 years old. I turned 8 years old that year. And my dad and I were watching the broadcast, and we'd go outside and look at the moon, and it was turning red, and I'd never seen that before. And then went inside, watched a little bit more of Jack, and I thought it was really cool. And then about a year or so later, he started the TV show Star Hustler. And I would usually watch Doctor Who. So as soon as Doctor Who was over, we would watch Star Hustler as PBT was signing off. And my parents took me to the planetarium, the Miami Space Transit Planetarium, when I was young. And we kept going back to see different shows. And one summer, when we were doing the anniversary of Child of the Universe, I happened to talk to one of the console operators there, who happened to be the production coordinator. And his name was Arthur Barton. And I asked him, how does a person get to do what you do? And he said, well, we could bring you on as an apprentice and have you teach you more about the constellations and show you how to operate the big machine in the center of the room, and then we can bring you on as an employee. And he introduced me to Jack Horkheimer, and I thought, wow, this is really cool. So I started working in the planetarium from when I was about 15 years old until I was about 21, 22 years old, and I went to the University of Florida to receive my degree in astronomy and physics, because I knew that astronomy was a passion, so I decided to do that for a living. And now I'm the director of the planetarium at Santa Fe College in Gainesville, Florida. Well, I've always been intrigued by planetary alignments and conjunctions. Conjunctions are when you get two or more planets lining up or being close to each other in the sky, either with each other or with the moon or with another star. So you can get some really pretty patterns at different times of the year, depending on our perspective as we go around the sun with the other planets. If you think about November, like October, November, Venus is going to be visible just after sunset in the west, and Jupiter will be visible in the east, so you can see both bright planets at the same time. You'll see one on one horizon, one on the other, and Jupiter will be in a great position where you can watch it all night long, because it's we'll be approaching what we call opposition, where we're on the opposite, where the sun is on the opposite side of the sky from Jupiter. So I always like observing the planets, and particularly with Jupiter, if you look at it through a small telescope, you can see four of the big moons, Io, Europa, Ganymede, and Callisto, and they're in a different position every time you look at them, because they all go around Jupiter relatively fast compared to our moon. Well, it's interesting, at the planetarium where I work, a lot of the kids, I ask them what their favorite planet is, and they always say Pluto. And the way I have to describe it is that because we've discovered so many planets around nearby stars, that we had to reclassify Pluto. So Pluto's, I guess you'd say, special compared to the other planets. It's a dwarf planet. So I do miss the fact that Pluto's not considered one of the major planets, but now it has four moons, so it's doing better than Mars and Earth. Even though its moons are smaller than our moon, but hey, you got four moons compared to one.